This video is going to be about determining whether a table or a graph represents a linear function. So since graphs are so easy, let's start with a graph. Basically, if you've got a graph, here's a graph, an x-axis and a y-axis, and you've got a straight line, then you're going to have a linear function. The only kind of straight line that's not going to be a linear function is going to be a vertical line, a line that goes straight up and down, because a vertical line would not pass the vertical line test. Any other straight line is going to be linear, and it's going to be a function because it will pass the vertical line test. So as far as graphs are concerned, all you've got to do is see whether the line is straight, make sure it's not vertical, and then you've got a linear function. Okay, let's go on to tables now. So here I've got a table of values. I've got an X column or an input column. So in the X column, I've got 5, 10, 20, and 25. And in the Y column or the output column, I've got 13, 10, 4, and 1. And we could look at these pairs of numbers, the 5 and 13, 10 and 10, 20 and 4, 25 and 1, as ordered pairs. So in other words, I can think of that 5 in the X column and the 13 in the Y column as just 5, 13. And the next pair of numbers, 10 and 10, I could think of as 10, 10. And I could label them X sub 1, Y sub 1, X sub 2 and Y sub 2. And then using the formula for slope, I could determine what the slope is going from the first pair of numbers to the second pair of numbers, which is like saying going from one point to another. So the formula for slope is that slope, or M, is Y sub 2 minus Y sub 1 over X sub 2 minus X sub 1. And now I just have to plug some numbers in. So y sub 2 is 10, and I'll subtract y sub 1, which is 13, and x sub 2 is 10, and I'll subtract x sub 1, which is 5, and I'm going to find out that the slope between the first point and the second point, or the first pair of numbers and the second pair of numbers, is negative 3 over 5. Okay, now I can find out the slope for between the second pair of numbers and the third pair of numbers. So let's see what that's going to be. So my second pair of numbers is 10, 10. We'll call that X sub 1 and Y sub 1. And the third pair of numbers, or the third point, is 20, 4. We'll call that X sub 2, y sub 2, and then subtracting y sub 2, taking y sub 2 and subtracting y sub 1, I've got 4 minus 10, and subtracting or taking the x sub 2 and subtracting x sub 1, so that's 20 minus 10. I'm going to get, let's see, 4 minus 10 is negative 6, 20 minus 10 is 10, and I can reduce that to negative 3 over 5. So that means the slope between the second pair of numbers and the third pair of numbers, or the second point and the third point, is negative 3/5. And the slope between the first point and the second point was also negative 3/5. So if the slope remains constant, then that would mean I have a straight line. Now, there's a faster way to do this rather than writing out the formula and everything. All we have to do is this. I'm going to find the differences between the numbers in the X column. So in other words, where I have 5 and 10, I'm going to take 10 and subtract 5, and the difference is 5. When I go from 10 to 20, I'll take 20 and subtract 10, and the difference is 10. Where I go from 20 to 25, I'll subtract 20 from 25, and the difference is 5. And now I'm going to do the same thing for the Y column. So 10 minus 13 is negative 3, And 4 minus 10 is negative 6. And 1 minus 4 is negative 3. And now, all I have to do is look at the differences and look at the ratio of the differences. In other words, I'm going to take the difference in the y column and look at the corresponding difference in the x column and make a fraction out of that. So that would mean I would have negative 3 over 5, which, remember, was the slope that I found. The next pair of differences, I've got negative 6 over 10, which reduces to negative 3 over 5, so the slope has remained the same. For the third pair of differences, I've got negative 3 over 5. Once again, the ratio, the slope, is negative 3 over 5. So since the slope has remained the same all the way through, I can consider this, I can determine that this is going to be a linear function. Let's see what would happen if it hadn't been a linear function. So I'm going to change one of the numbers here. Instead of having 13, 10, and then 4 in the y column, I'll make this 13, 10, and then 3. So now my differences in the y column will be 10 minus 13 is negative 3, and 3 minus 10 is negative 7, and then 1 minus 3 is negative 2. Well, now when I look at those ratios, I've still got negative 3 over 5 for the first ratio that I'm making. So that would be a slope of negative 3/5. Then I go to negative 7 over 10. Negative 7 over 10 cannot be reduced, so it's not going to be the same as negative 3 over 5. And then I go to negative 2 over 5, which also cannot be reduced, so I have not got a constant slope. If I don't have a constant slope, I don't have a linear function. Okay? So that's basically all you have to do. You're finding the differences between the numbers in your input column, or your x column. You're finding the differences between the numbers in your output column, or your y column. And then you're looking at the ratio, the fraction that you create from those differences, comparing the y column as the numerator, or the difference in the y column, to the difference in the x column. And if you keep getting the same fraction each time you do that, then you've got a linear function. If you don't get the same fraction, this happens over here, then the function is not linear. Okay? So I hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.